What's up, everybody? My name is Cap, and you're watching some Kill Confirmed on the Matt Slums, playing some Black Ops 2. I'm using the Scorpion EVO, it's a SMG. I have fast mags and laser sight attachment on there, because it really, really helps out with aim from the hip and fire from the hip. Perks, I'm using Hardline, Fast Hands, Dexterity, and Extreme Conditioning. Simtex and Concussion, no secondary. And as far as point streaks go, I'm using the UAV, Hunter Killer, and Lightning Strike. That seems to be my go-to setup basically for playing Kill Confirmed. Either that or like in my last video using the R870 shotgun. I really like those. Get in, you know, fast and move around and jump on people and, you know, kick their ass basically and be able to, you know, get in and out really quickly, whatever. And I like using the low kill streaks. You know, like UAV, of course, it helps bring everybody on the map and you get assist points for it. Hunter Killer Drone because it just takes off and does this thing. And Lightning Strike because it kind of, I don't know, I kind of use it to funnel them in to where I want them to go there. But that's kind of my favorite setup to use for playing Kill Confirmed. Now, occasionally, I'll switch it off of UAV and I'll go Hunter Killer Drone, Lightning Strike, Hellstorm Missile. I've been really getting out of the habit of trying to use kill streaks that are manned. You know, like the what's that thing called? The Lodestar and a couple of those other ones there. And the main reason why is just because they get shot down so quickly, and, you know, I can understand why. I mean, if I'm on the defending side of one of them bad boys coming in, I don't want to get rid of it as quickly as possible, too. But when you're the one using it, and you finally get this beast-ass kill streak and can, you know, finally just start rain and terror on them, and then they either back out or shoot it down, it's very disheartening. So, anyway, whoops, check out that fail. Shoot him, knife him, can't get the kill, go ahead and reload and try this again. But I see this dude camped out down there hiding, he thinks he's got me, waiting for it, and boom, he's dead. Ah, suck it. Anyway, this is one of my favorite maps to play Kill Confirmed on. That's what I was going to kind of focus this video on here, this commentary on, is my favorites for this game here. Now, I'm stupid, didn't see the guy coming up behind me, but when it comes to playing Kill Confirmed, I really like Slums, I like the Meltdown, that's a really good one there. Basically places where you can get from A to B and have a lot of, you know, corners, not really corners, but a lot of turns, and it's not such a wide open straightaway. See, here's good straightaway, but there's vans blocking the corners and stuff like that. It's just, I don't know, it seems to help out a lot with people camping, because then I can get all across the map and it's not such a big deal. And when it comes to weapons, my favorite SMG is the Scorpion. That's the gun I'm going to be taking with me when I prestige and take my perk, I mean my prestige token, and go ahead and use that because I really like this gun. It fires insanely fast. And, you know, my tip for people that are having, like, connection issues and it's like, oh man, every time I run into somebody, I lose the battle up close and personal because such and such gun just sucks. Give the Scorpion a try. It's got a fast rate of fire, it's accurate from the hip, especially if you have the laser sight on it, and so really the only time you get outgunned is if somebody has a faster one, you know, like they put a rapid fire on their Scorpion or whatever, or if they have the shotgun. And, you know, you just take that as you can. Kill streaks, like I said, I really, you know, I prefer using the unmanned kill streaks, the ones that don't take me out of the game for very long. Now, I know using the Hellstorm Missile and the Lightning Strike or whatever, those do require me to, you know, open up the old laptop and check out where I want to drop it and call it good or whatever like that, but I don't mind it so much because it's something I can do really quickly and have it still be effective, versus if it's something that I have to, like, a care package, I have to wait for it to get in and wait for, you know, hope I don't get my ass kicked beforehand. So, you know, that's my preferred setup here. The favorite shotgun I like is the R870, and I've used that in a previous video. I've tried the KSG and that slug gun. Now, it's a very powerful shotgun if you hit them. That's the thing about that is, like, you have to ADS when you're shooting at them. If not, you're going to miss. Knife! Suck it, bitch. And, because if you try and shoot from the hip, you're going to miss, and it's going to be a horrible miss, and you're going to die. Now, those are the only two shotguns I've tried. There may be some better ones out there. Hell, if you know a better one than the 870, let me know. I'll try it out, too, because I'm interested in this next prestige. I'm going to try and use some weapons I didn't use. I don't know what to think about the assault rifles, man. I haven't used one yet that I'm just like, oh my god, that's the best gun I've ever used. I have, you know, I like the SCAR. It's good for taking out enemies at a distance, really, but man, if you up close, that gun is hard to freaking get anything with. It's ridiculous here. I don't know. Anytime I run into somebody, especially close quarters, even shooting from the hip, and I don't know. I just don't have the skill or whatever it is. That I don't know what the problem is, but I cannot use assault rifles in close quarters. Now, if it was like here, I'd, you know, pop out of the laundry room here and aim down the street and kind of wait for somebody to move. If I want to play a slower tactic, yeah, I'll see if the assault rifles are good. I've used the, what is it, the MTAR? Is that what it's called? Hell, honestly, I can't remember what it is now. I've tried a couple ones. I really suck at burst fire weapons or single shot weapons like the FAL. Man, I know some people that just live by that gun. They think it's like the best gun since sliced bread. And I know that makes no sense, but they just really can beast with it. Me, I get it, and I might get a lucky shot, but there's definitely no streaks coming from it. I'm not very good at pistols, man. I don't know. I can't find one that just fits very good. I find myself, I don't know, not having enough ammo or something. I don't know what the problem is, but I just really suck with them. And I have not used an LMG at all. Unless it's like a gun game, of course, when it forces me to use it. So I don't have a favorite one of those, and they really don't fit my play style because I like to play like I am here. You know, dead sprint, running balls to the walls in enemy territory and just really trying to piss everybody off. And you can't do that if your gun slows you down. You know, your walking speed on them bastards is incredibly slow. It takes forever to bring them up. And now I know every gun can probably have a little bit better stats, whatever, if you grind them up a little bit, but... Wow, double fail here. But anyway, that's pretty much it. I've unlocked, this video is a couple days old now, so I am in level 55, so I'm close to being able to prestige, check out that little two-piece, run around, just pick up tags like magnets. I will be prestiging pretty soon. I may spend a couple rounds at 55 just so I can finally use some of the perks and crap I finally unlocked, because... Oh, I really wish they would make the max thing you unlock is like level 50. You know, it's just that way you can keep playing for a few rounds after you prestige and you don't have to worry about losing it. You know, you don't get ghost until level 55. So if you're quick to prestige, you get, 10 rounds maybe and then it's done. You can't play with it anymore. That's no bueno. Going along with my favorites, I can say my least favorite map is Turbine. I really don't like that map, and you know what, the map design itself could be really good, but it is just the way it's played. I have yet to play a single game on that map, any game mode, kill confirmed, TDM, domination, hardpoint, demolition, search and destroy. I have yet to play a single game mode on that map that the entire damn enemy team wasn't sniping, and I don't mean like quickscoping. Yeah, we've run into a few lobbies like that where everybody was trickscoping off the plane trying to get their montage wub wub going on. But most of the time, it's people hiding in the corners, sitting in the backs, not moving, get my enemy, I was trying to chase that guy down and he got killed by a hailstorm missile, I think it was. Anyway, so that is the one map I just cannot stand. There's a few other, I'm not a big fan of Raid. I don't know, that center courtyard area, it's always such a big choke point. I'm just not really a fan of it, but I really like this map. The more and more I play it, and looking through my gameplays that I have saved up of, I might make a video out of sort of thing. I have like 4 or 5 on this particular map. And that's cool with me. Like I said, Meltdown's cool. I do okay on Plaza sometimes. It just kind of depends on the player pool, of course, that's on the other team. And I really can't remember that many other maps. Yemen's kind of cool. You can get in and out kind of quickly on that one as long as people aren't hiding in the windows. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Now this video is kind of wrapping up. I'm going to get one more here, and then I think I'm about to go ahead and end this streak on something stupid. Didn't get enough ammo to kill him, panic knife, miss, die, blah blah blah, fail. And we rack it up with a quick kill right there. So I had 46 and 20 with 35 picks. I think that's what that says. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Y'all have a good one, and I'll talk to you later.